Okay, let's turn our Bible, Acts chapter 20, verse 29 and 30. Acts 29 and 30. For I know this, that after my departing shall grievous wolves enter in among you, not sparing the flock. Also of your own selves shall men arise, speaking perverse things to draw away disciples after them. Amen. This address, Paul said to the saints, be careful, the wolves from outside, and also be careful, the people who arise among us inside. So the Satan used the people destroy the church from outside and inside. So be careful both sides. So maybe among you or in among the church member, someday the people arise and destroy the church. Okay. The Bible Presbyterian Church also no exception. So, Bible Presbyterian Church in Singapore divide the several part, not by outsider, insiders. Okay? So they arose among us and destroy the good report of the church. Okay, last time we was thinking about the Adopting Act. But the Adopting Act was the necessary, but some compromise. So one parties, they want to subscribe, but the other party, they want to bubble declaration. So different lines. Okay, one is more strict, another party is the losing, okay? Losing part. Okay, but these two parties has had a different view on the Great Awakening. The Great Awakening, the referring to several periods of religious revival in American religious history. The first Great Awakening began in the 1730s and lasted to about 1750s. The second Great Awakening began in the late 18th century and lasted until the middle of the 19th century. The third Great Awakening in 1850 to 1910 was characterized by new denominations, very active missionary work, and also the social gospel approach the social issues. So the three times, first, second, and third Great Awakening. By the subscribing, these subscribing parties more strict, we call this parties subscriptionalist. By bubble declaration, losing bubble list. The subscriptionalists, they had a negative attitude on the Great Awakening. Toward the Great Awakening, we call them anti-awakening side. And the losing bubbles, they had a positive attitude toward the great awakening. We call them pro-awakening side. It's very interesting. The strict subscription list, they were anti-awakening. But the losing bubbles, they were pro-awakening side. The challenge, the great awakenings was appealing to feeling than to teaching the Bible, even emphasizing Christian conduct and doctrine. The crucial collision between anti-awakening side and pro-awakening side was burst out by Gilbert Tennant, who was a leader of pro-awakening side and a pastor of the Presbytery of New Brunswick. The Gilbert Tennant, at March 8, 1740, he attacked the anti-awakening side by his sermon titled On the Danger of an Unconverted Ministry at Nottingham in Pennsylvania. He compared anti-awakening side minister to the Pharisees. The replying to Gilbert Tennant, anti-awakening side called him New Light to identify him a heretic. John Hancock reputed Gilbert Tennant's sermon through his own sermon titled The Danger of Unqualified Ministry. It's very interesting. Two streams, okay? The strict scripturalist, they were anti-awakening side. And losing bubbly, they were pro-awakening side. And the leader of pro-awakening side, Gilbert Tennant, attacked the anti-awakening side with his sermon titled On the Danger of an Unconverted Ministry. So Gilbert Tennant said, you who against awakening, great awakening, you are the unconverted ministry. You are the Pharisees. So, the anti-awakening side, they replied to Gilbert Tennant, especially the John Hancock, his own sermon titled The Danger of Unqualified Ministry. So here, we can see two streams, okay? So if you ask me, what is my position? I am a strict subscriptionalist, and I am the anti-awakening side, okay? The old side, new side controversy. The name of the split that occurred during the first Great Awakening in the American Presbyterian Church. John Thompson was a leader of the old side. The old side, they came out from anti-awakening side. He opposed the revivalistic measures. He was called unconverted and received much abuse. So all the people in America, they were very touched with the Great Awakening side. But some pastors, they against Great Awakening side. So majority attacked these people, you are unconverted. In 1741, John Thompson, along with several other ministers and elders, signed the protestation regarding the conduct of those who had it to the new side or the pro-awakening side. Now, strict subscription list, and they became the anti-awakening side. Now they became old side, okay? Now the losing bubble list, they became pro-awakening side, and now they became new side, okay? Both ensued regarding the protest, and the protesters came out in the majority and led to the withdrawal of new side brethren. The new side created their own presbytery, the conjunct presbytery, and would later form the Synod of New York. John Thompson continued as a member of Synod of Philadelphia. So now there are two sides. The Synod of Philadelphia for old side, the Presbytery of New Brunswick, and Presbytery of New York, the Synod of New York, the new side. So one for the Synod of Philadelphia for new side, the Synod of New York, the new side. The old school and new school controversy. Now the old side became old school, new side became new school. We call this old school and new school controversy. A schism of the Presbyterian Church in the United States of America, which began in 1837. It called for tradition Calvinist Orthodox as outlined in the Westminster Standards. The old school, led by Charles Hutch of Princeton Theological Seminary. He was much more conservative theologically and was much less supportive of revivals. He is the leader of old school. In the 1820s, the New Haven theology of Nathaniel William Taylor interpreted regeneration as essentially voluntary. It means you have to decide to believe in Jesus Christ with your own will. Okay? But the New Haven theology to line up historical Calvinism with the religious revivalism of the time, the Second Great Awakening. And in 1822, the Yale Divinity School, located in New Haven, Connecticut, was created, and Nathaniel Taylor was appointed its first professor. He became the central figure in the seminary in the minds of the students. So, the Yale University has new theology. We call this New Haven theology. Okay? But this New Haven theology some little bit depart from Calvinistic traditions. It looks like Arminianism, or this follow the Pelagius in Middle Age. So some Calvinistic theologians, they reject the New Haven theology. Okay, let's go to the Harvard University and Yale University. These two universities was established to train Presbyterian ministers. But later, they were secularized and occupied by some heretical theologians. Harvard University started with a new college 1636, changed the name Harvard College because Harvard, he donated a lot of money for the college, so they changed the name Harvard College. It became later Harvard University. The takeover of Harvard University by the Unitarians in 1805 resulted in the secularization of the American college. By 1850, Harvard was the Unitarian Vatican. Unitarianism denied the Trinity. They believe only God the Father. They reject the God in Trinity. So Unitarian, they occupy the Harvard University. So the Presbyterian Church cannot send a student to Harvard University. So they made another university. This is the Yale University. Okay? The Harvard University's motto, first time, Veritas Christo et Ecclesiae. It means truth for Christ and Church. But nowadays, they delete for Christ and Church. So only they have the name Veritas. Okay? So no more for Christ and Church. It is a symbol of the secularization. Okay? So let's see the motto of Harvard University. Then let's see the right side. We can see the motto of Yale University. Lux et Veritas means light and truth. You can see the Hebrew word. This is Urim ve Tumim. This is the two stones of high priest, Urim and Tumim. Looks at Veritas. Yale University traced its route to 17th century clergymen who sought to establish a college to train clergymen political leaders for a colony. In 1718, the college was renamed Yale College. From this college, the New Haven theology came out. So the Presbyterian, to train the Presbyterian ministers, the Princeton Theological Seminary was established. 1812, established the first seminary founded by the General Assembly of the Presbyterian Church. The motto, they served numine viget. Under God's power, she flourishes. But later, 1924, the Princeton Theological Seminary also gave up the biblical truth. The liberals, they occupied the Princeton Theological Seminary. So J. Gresham Machen, he established new seminary called the Westminster Theological Seminary. Motto was Pas Hae Bule Tu Theou, the whole counsel of God. Later, from this seminary, some faithful and sincere ministers came out from Westminster Theological Seminary. They established another Bible college. This is the Faith Theological Seminary, a fundamental seminary founded in 1937. It was founded by Carl McIntyre and Alan McCree and Olive Boswell, who served as its first
Alan Macri was the first president, principal of the Faith Theological Seminary. The motto was for the faith by the faith. But later, now the Faith Theological Seminary in USA, now they lost all the previous good things, okay? So now almost became the new evangelicals. They are not fighting anymore. The spirit of the Faith Theological Seminary came to the Far Eastern Bible College in Singapore, holding fast the word of life, holding fast the faithful word. Now Far Eastern Bible College serving the word of God to depend against every attacks from outside or inside. The old school rejected this idea as heresy, New Haven theology, and old school was attractive to the Scottish-Irish element. What's the Scottish-Irish element? It's a doctrine, a Westminster standards, and the traditional Christianity. The old school wanted to hold fast to Calvinistic tradition, while the new school was tolerable to adjust the traditional doctrines. So the new school in 19th century, they emphasized Christian conduct and moral reform to make America an evangelical empire. Until today, it is working with the new evangelicals. New evangelicals, they want to make America the evangelical empire. But sometimes they are compromised. They support the politicians, but until today, it is not successful. Okay? The main program for this purpose was the revivalism, and a new interpretation on the doctrines was followed. Okay? So they compromised, and they adjust all the doctrines with the worldly thought. So, first time, it was only the attitude. They just compromised, and they want to get the fame in the area of theology. So they must accept all reasoning and scientific method. But later, they adjust further, they compromise, and further, they deny some biblical truths. Even I read one book about the Old Testament theology. In that book, of course, it was written by new evangelical, said the Adam, he was not the first man. Before Adam, there were many peoples, okay? So what is the Adam? He is only one in covenant, okay? So they adopted the evolutionary theories, okay, in theology. So also they developed the creation, doctrine of creation. They harmonized and they mixed with the evolutionary theory, with the creation record. Okay, we call this theistic evolutionary theology, something blah, blah, blah. Okay, anyway, the Lord used the evolution to create this universe, heaven and earth. So the age of this earth very old. thousand million years. Okay, not 6,000 or 7,000. They compromise. And even they deny some record of creations. This is new evangelicals. Okay. Let's see two lines in the American Presbyterian Church. Two lines in the American Presbyterian Church. Okay. Martin Luther Reformation, John Calvin Reformed Theology, beginning. John Knox Presbyterian Church in Scotland, but another line, Puritans in England. Okay? So, Scottish, Irish, Northern Ireland, also the England, it developed into the Pietism settlement. They immigrate to America, the Scottish, Irish, and Scottish men, people, they settled down in Philadelphia. And Puritan, usually they were settled down the Long Island. The 1727 Adopting Act, the Presbyterians, the conservative Presbyterians from Scotland, they were strict subscriptionalists. But the Long Island, the Puritans, they were losing bubbleist. First awakening, the Scottish, the Presbyterian, they became anti-awakening side. But the losing bubbleist, they became pro-awakening side. And split, 1741. The anti-awakening side became old side, Synod of Philadelphia, and pro-awakening side, they became new side, Synod of New York. From this time, Synod of Philadelphia always conservative and fundamental, but the new side, Synod of New York, always liberal. The schism, 1833, old side became old school traditional Reformed theology. And new side, Synod of New York, they became new school with new heaven theology. And later, 1920s, the fundamentalism and liberalism controversy, the old school supported the fundamentalist, but the new school supporting neutrals or liberals. Okay? So clearly two lines in American church history in Presbyterian church. Okay? From John Knox to fundamentalists, from Puritans England to neutral or liberals. Okay? So remember these two lines in the American Presbyterian churches. So this line is very, very important. You are brought up in this kind of tradition, good traditions, automatically you learning about all these precious doctrines. Of course, some of you will stray from these good things. Nevertheless, the majority still remain these precious traditions. But the other side, they always brought up in some different doctrine, different custom, different concept of mind. And the majority of this line will follow their ancestor, their forefathers. Okay? So now we have to touch what is liberalism and what is modernism before talking about fundamentalism, because fundamentalism is the reaction against liberalism or modernism. So before talking about the fundamentalism, we have to think about the liberalism and modernism first. A liberal is the one who is free from doctrine. So we are a bond man. Okay, we are bound in doctrine. So we cannot deny the doctrine. Doctrine and theory is quite different. We cannot change the doctrine. Can you change the doctrine of Trinity? Cannot. We can change the doctrine of two nature of Christ. We cannot. If you change something, everybody say to you, you are heretic. Okay? So we cannot change the doctrine. How about the theory? We can change theory. Why? Theory is not doctrine. Someone has this kind of theory, but after 10 years, 20 years, it must be changed by new theory. This is the science. Okay, but so liberal is one who is free from doctrine, means no any limitation by the word of God. They want to say anything, they want to think anything, they want to do anything. This is liberals. Okay? How about homosexuals, lesbians? Why we strongly against this kind of things? Because Bible said this is sin. But someone free from the Bible, free from the law of God, they can think freely, they can do freely, they can say freely. They said homosexual is the alternative way. Is it true? No. This is difference from liberals and conservatives. Liberals criticize everything with his own reason. Liberal has called him a modernist because they said we are modernized people. We are walking on via moderna. Liberals, usually, they are enemies of Christianity. What? Who is the Christians? Christians, in name, the name Christian tells us the identity of the, or identity who Christian is. Christian means Christ bearer. It means they are people of Christ. What kind of Christ? Of course, this Christ is the Christ in the Bible. So we believing in the Bible, we believing in the Christ in the Bible. But liberals, they denied all the record. Also, they denied Christ, the Christ in the Bible. They are not believing Jesus Christ is the Son of God. They said Jesus Christ is an ordinary person like us. Someone said he is the sinful man, and he is even, someone said, he is bastard. Okay? This is blasphemy. This is a liberal concept. They do not believe in the Bible. They do not believe in the Christ in the Bible. They despise. Even they mock. Liberal restate Christianity according to modern categories. So they cannot understand all the miracles in the Bible, and they adjust. They allegorize all the miracles, all the record in the Bible according to the modern categories. So they made all the historical record in the Bible into myth. So they said, oh, this is looks like a Greek myth. Okay, so you cannot believe this. It cannot bring you the salvation. So we have to find historical Jesus in the Bible. This looks like sound good, but actually they deny all the record in the Bible. What is modernism? Another name of liberalism. It is regarded that this term was used by Pius X, firstly, the Roman Pope, Pius X, firstly. It used a method on via moderna, new way. Via antiqua, via moderna. We are working on via antiqua. We are taking the old path, old way, the traditions. But the via moderna, they reject old way, old traditions. They are working on via moderna, new way. In church history, via moderna means a heresy. There is nothing new in theology except heresy, spoken by Charles Haddon Spurgeon. He said he knew very well, because in his day he found some new way, via moderna. He said there is nothing new in theology except heresy. Here, new means via moderna, heresy. Severe term than liberalism, Pius X and modernism. Lamentabili sane exitu, with truly lamentable result, is a 1907 syllabus prepared by the Holy Office and compounded by Pope Pius X, which condemned errors in the exegesis of Holy Scripture and in the history and interpretation of dogma. The syllabus itself does not use the term modernist, but was regarded as part of the Pope's campaign against modernism in general and philosophical evolutionism in particular. So actually the modernism, the term, was used by Roman Catholics. Even Roman Catholics say the modernism is a heresy. Okay? First time, this is not by Protestant, this is by Roman Catholic popes. They also hate the liberalism and modernism, because the modernists, they denied all the authority, all the traditions, even in Roman Catholic Church. Also, we Protestant also against the modernists, because they destroyed all the truths in the Bible. So we also against the modernist. Okay, let's see the features of the new theology. New theology means modernism and liberalism and some heretical thought. We can see this book by David O'Beale, page 84. Relativistic view of the Bible. What's this? For us, Bible is the only one and final and supreme authority. But the liberals, modernists, they had some relative concept. This is not the only authority. They had another authority, like reason or science. Okay? So now, people, they are believing the doctors and the professors rather than pastors, rather than the Bible. Why? Because they had a relativistic view of the Bible. But we are not. The Bible has a supreme authority in every areas. Even the religious area, also the political area, also economical area, also this kind of time, the pandemic situations, the Bible has final authorities. So, what we have to do this like this time? Of course, the Bible says you must repent your sin. Okay? So, whether we die or live, it's not matter actually. If you truly believe in Jesus Christ, after your death, you are going to heaven, the bosom of your heavenly Father. No problems. So this time, we have to evangelize to unbelievers, okay? And give them the gospel light, because they cannot see the truth until today. But they must repent their sin. They must come back to the Lord. Right? This is the Bible. The relativistic view of the Bible, but we believe that the Bible is only one and final and supreme authority for every area. The humanistic emphasis on the innate goddess of man. Actually, this concept comes from Eastern thought, like Hinduism and Buddhism. They said, from the beginning, the human being has some deity in them, but the environment makes some limitation to develop this deity. So, someone develop their deity, they can be a god. But this god is not big, capital letter god, but small letter god. Anyway, they can be a god. This is the humanistic emphasis. Okay? But the Bible says we are all sinners except Jesus Christ. We cannot have any freedom. We cannot be a God, right? So we are still sinners. But this humanistic emphasis, they brought another way of salvation. So be careful, this kind of thinking. This comes from the modernistic ideas. Humanistic emphasis on the innate goodness of man. Okay? And also they are thinking the human being has some good things in them. Okay? But the Bible says no. All human beings were born in sin. So we have the original sin from beginning our life. Why we commit sin? Because we are sinners. Right? Original sin bring us commit sin. The third, the Bible and Christendom conditioned by history. It means the Deuteronomy and Genesis and Numbers, Leviticus, this kind, Joshua, it was written before 3,500 years ago. So, some record of this Bible is conditioned by history. This all the Bible contains the mentality of the that time. Even the Gospel of Matthew, Mark, Luke, John also contains some environment, some ideas and conditions that time. So we have to adjust to understand this record correctly in modern day, our day, we have to study history. Okay? So we have to take out the limitation by history. So we have to adjust all the meaning. So, for example, we cannot accept all the record of creation literally. Okay, compared with science, how can we believe all the record of creation? So we have to adjust. This is a matter of history. This kind of concept comes from new theology. Fourth, emphasis on the immanence of God, resulting in no gap between natural revelation and special revelation, and a tendency toward pantheism. What pantheism? In Greek, pan means every. Theism is the related with God, right? All God. Okay. So this kind of concept is not allow God, the Trinity God. This allowed all the gods in the world. Okay? No gap between natural revelation and special revelation. What is natural revelation? Natural revelation, we can get the revelation from creature. Also, the human being is the creature. Human being has the reason, reasoning also one part of natural revelation. Okay? So we can know God from natural revelation. Also, we can know God with special revelation. Special revelation is the Bible. But this idea is not the new concept. We already knew the medieval church, okay? So, you know, the triangle, two ways to God. One is the special revelation, one is the natural revelation. This is not new concept. So someone said modernism and liberalism is quite new. No. The heresies or heretical thought came out from the beginning of Christianity. They repeated itself. Number five, the evolution and optimism about human progress. It means human being has a good things in them, and they develop these good things. The society or the system evaluated, and finally, in the end of this world, we'll have paradise. This is optimism. Okay? But because they trust the reason and scientific development. Okay? But after the World War First and World War Second and the Korean Civil War, every war in the world, they do not trust this kind of optimism. But until 2 months ago, the people still has the optimism because by science, all the world was developing. I've been developing very well. So they said, oh, no problem. We will control the earth, our economy, and everything. What do you want? But now is this pandemic situations all collapsed down. Now we are confined in this compound boundary. Okay, we cannot go out. Even we cannot go out from this country. Okay, now I have to go Tanzania, but I don't know when I could come to Tanzania. I don't know. We cannot control. So it is one evidence of the end time. So Jesus Christ will come soon. Okay? This is not optimism, okay? But the liberals and the modernists, they always, evaluation, has always evaluation and optimism about human progress. But human being always disappointed human being. Number six, concern for human personality and its development. They had also optimistic view for human personality and its development. They said humanity will be better and better. Is it true? I was very young. My village people were so kind, you know. We have no food in my house. They share all the food, okay? So my mother was working at the field, and the friends of my mother, they call me and give me food with their children. No boundaries, okay? But that time is very rare to kill someone, okay? But how about nowadays? All the sexual sins and violence and war, stealing, robbery, everything around the world. Not human, it's no optimism for human personality. Getting worse and worse. No development, backsliding. Only Christians who has the law of God, they can have the good life. Okay, but the others. Now, we are fighting in Korea, we are fighting for the, some law. The government want to make one law, do not, despise the minority, including the homosexuals, okay? After making this law, we cannot preach in, on the pulpit against the homosexuality. Then, the homosexuals, they sue us because against the law, we despise them, okay? This is the law. How about Singapore? How about America, USA? Now USA cannot preach against homosexuality. Pray for this. No development of human personality, getting worse and worse. And seven, dialogue as primarily a practical enterprise. What's this? Now, in Bible college in USA, the, for MD course, they are not teaching the Greek and Hebrew. It's very difficult. They do not need anymore to preach God's word. Because the church, of majority church, became a business place. So now they are using counseling and leadership and business administration to run the church. The practical enterprise, okay? It's very sad. But I'm thank God for Fires and Bible College still teach them the Greek and Hebrew to expound the Word of God. It's very good to study hard and learn how to draw out the meaning of the Bible from original text. So, finish all the language course. It is good for yourself and good for your congregation. Okay? Don't make the mystery of the Lord as a business. Okay? In the mission field, I see something. Now, everybody said the BAM. What is BAM? Business as mission. It means the layman missionary come to mission field. He is doing business and he is making money, and he no need any support from the churches. Okay, he building the school and building the hospitals, and he make money. Now, Tanzanian government decide do not give any missionary visa because all the missionary is doing the business. So, Tanzanian government asked to missionaries, you must get the business visa, not missionary visa, because you are the businessman. Okay, you are making the money. And they are making money, very big money, from the Africans, Tanzanians, okay? So 1 year, the one student must pay $1,500, one student. But around 1,000 students there, so they make a lot of money. But this is very, very big money for Tanzanians. So government said, until today, we know the missionaries, they always bring the money and spend the money for Africans. Okay? For food and for education, everything. But now, you never spend your money. But you are collecting money from Africans. Okay? So we believe you are not the missionary. You are just businessman. This is the condition of Tanzania. So, genuine missionary who never run the business, but they cannot survive. Okay? So all the missionary must leave from Tanzania. So I can stay there next year, July. No more. What's this? Don't make the ministry as business, okay? So this is not the conservative Christian concept. This is the concept of the liberalism, modernism. They destroy all the mission works. They destroy all the church. Okay? Now they are running the church as a business, not the preaching the gospel. And also low view of sin. Sin is sin, right? Someone kill, if you saw one man, kill one man, murder one man, and the judge will rebuke you, and you he confine you in cell. But if you kill 100 men with very, I cannot explain this, very terrible way, kill them, the judge will not put you in cell, in jail. He will put in mental hospital. This is not sin anymore. This is a mental problem, eh? Sickness of your mental. It's ridiculous, you know. Today's This comes from low view of sin. This day did not believe in sin. If you have some bad habit, you beat your friends, the scholars, the counselors, and counsel you, tell me about your parents. Did your parents beat you in childhood? It will maybe this kind of thing give you some the stigma, okay? The painful the memories. So you cannot control your life. So you also not the criminals, okay? You are the victim of your parents. You are not sinners, okay? Something wrong. This is a low view of sin. So today, we say to them, repent your sin. Everybody said, we have no sin. I'm also a victim. I have only mental problem. I must be treated by doctors. No sin. I'm not a sinner. Okay, this is low view of sin. A strong social emphasis. What is social emphasis? It's related with the social gospels. We want to change the society. Easiest way is evangelize someone. Okay? So, now, my wife is writing, wrote one exegetical paper on the Philemon. Okay, here we can find one man. The once upon a time he was a sinner, but he repented and believed in Jesus Christ. His name Onesimus. Okay, and he was a slave, and he took the money from his master Philemon. And he ran away, but he met the Apostle Paul, and through the Apostle Paul, he believed in Jesus Christ. And his life was changed. In the history, the record of the Eusebius, the Onesimus, he became a bishop of the Church of Rome later. He was changed. He became the useful man. This is the way how can we transform the church, transform the society, transform the persons. But the liberals and the modernists, they are not believing in sin. Okay? So they said we must change the system of society, because every man is good, but they sometimes make wrong. Why? Because system is wrong. The human being, nothing wrong. So they focus on society to change the systems. Okay, so they brought the education, they brought the hospital, they brought the food, but human being never changed. The sinner is still sinners. Now, they focused on a lot of the problems of society, but society never changed. But we evangelize one man, he believed in Jesus Christ, he will change his own house, and the house will change the society, villages, towns, and nations. This is, we are focused on the person. The sinner must repent and come back to the Lord. 10. Neglect of the doctrine of the church. What's this? They make the church as a community.
They come to the church not for gospel of Jesus Christ, but they want to listen to good word, address. And they want to have some relationship each other. If you run one business company, you need a client. You can find a client in the church. Outside of the church and inside of the church is nothing difference, same. So a lot of people, they don't want to come to church because everything comes from the church. They can have experience outside of the church, no? So if we preach the gospel in the church, then we can find genuine Christians. We can make some, we can help someone to be a genuine Christian preaching the gospel. Church must be different from the world. But now they mixed because this is a neglection of the doctrine of the church. This influenced by modernists and liberals. Okay? 11, emphasis on Christ's humanity and neglect or denial of his deity. The liberals and modernists, they are not believing in that Jesus Christ is the Son of God. They only believe in that Jesus Christ is a human being. That's all. But the Bible says Jesus Christ is the Son of God because they do not believe in the Word of God. The Bible is not God's Word. Okay? 12, moral influence view of the atonement. Hey, what is the atonement? This English word comes from at one month. Jesus Christ, he died on the cross to save us from our sin. He gave himself as a sacrifice at once. This is atonement. Okay? But it's not just moral influence. Okay? This is a sacrificial sacrifice. Jesus Christ, he died on the cross. It's not just moral influence. So liberal, they never focus on the death of Jesus Christ, his burial, his resurrection, or second coming of Jesus Christ. They always focus on his moral influence. So liberals, they focus on the Matthew chapter 5 to 7. But it's not the all. This is one part of the mystery of Jesus Christ. They said Jesus Christ is the good teacher for moral influence. But we believe in that Jesus Christ is the Savior. He died for us on the cross. And universalism in the theology, universalism means Jesus Christ, he died for all, even whether he believed in or he is not. Okay, no matter, Jesus Christ is dead for every man. I heard one liberal preaching. He was a very good preacher, very powerful preacher. And he preached death of Jesus Christ. And he said, Old Testament, the people used the animal as a sacrifice. So even through this animal sacrifice, someone's sin was cleansed.
But nowadays, the Son of God, Jesus Christ, He died for us as a sacrifice. The influence, the power is more than the animal sacrifice. So, He said, animal sacrifice saved only one who brought the sacrificial animals. But the blood of Jesus Christ, more precious. So, it's enough for believers and also unbelievers. So, everybody must be saved by the blood of Jesus Christ, whether he is believing Jesus Christ or not. Sound good? But the Bible says no. Only the elect would be saved by the blood of Jesus Christ. We are not believing in the universalism. Okay? So, of course, I believe the enough for all the people on the earth, the blood of Jesus Christ, the power of blood of Jesus Christ, but only effectual for the elect. So, sufficient for all, efficient for the elect. Remember this word. And 14, emphasis on religion rather than Bible Christianity. What is the religion? They said all religion has their own salvation way. So Christianity, of course, we have the salvation way, but the Muslims also their own salvation way. And the Buddhist, they also has the salvation way. Okay? So they say no more evangelism. We have to talk with them. Let's study each other. Let's respect. Let's love each other. Okay? So WCC, the World Council of Churches, these churches, not the only Christian churches, these churches, all the churches of all the religions, okay? But against WCC, Dr. Carl McIntyre, he established ICCC, International Council of Christian Churches. Okay, this is very conservative and fundamental agency against the WCC. Okay? So, they said, the liberals said, Christianity is not the only way of salvation, but the other religion also had the way of salvation. I was 18 years old. The one professor of the Methodist church, he preached. At that time, I visited my friend's church. He preached this story. There was one father. He, just before his death, he called his four sons and told him, I hid some treasure in the field. Okay, and you find it and share each other's, okay, share these things. So they believe their father and they dig all the field. But they couldn't find this. And finally they decide to sow the seed, okay. So after a few months they can harvest all the wheat, okay? And that time, they recognized what was the treasure from the father. That's not the jewels, okay? This kind of the wheat and the love. The brotherly love, okay? And he concluded the first brother, the elder brother is a Christian. The second brother is a Muslim. And third brother, Buddhist. And fourth brother, Confucianist. Okay? He said, these all religion are brothers. They have only one father. That time I was the born-again Christians. Oh, there's something wrong. How can the Christians and Muslim and Buddhist and Confucianist can be a brother? They don't have Jesus Christ. We have Jesus Christ. I was saved by Jesus Christ, but they don't have the Jesus Christ. How can the man say? Later, I researched who is this man. Of course, he was a very, very famous liberal theologian. Okay? So, but in mission field, I found a lot of missionaries from liberal denominations, okay? But they believed the other religions has a salvation way. But why they bring Jesus Christ to them? They're ridiculous. It's irony. So next time I saw them, okay, I understand. They never preached the gospel of Jesus Christ. They brought the food. They established the school. They established the hospital. But they never preached the gospel of Jesus Christ. This is the new mission. But it's not actual new mission. The John Gresham Machens, he was fighting against liberal missionaries also. The 15, antipathy toward orthodoxy. They don't like the traditions, okay? Traditions is like a old way. They don't want to be a old man. They have the name modernist, means they always want to go to new way. Okay? So they hate the orthodoxy. But we love the word orthodoxy. Okay? The rationalism, I already told you, rationalism is their God is a reason. The reasoning, also with the science. It's not scientific. It's not against the science, against reason. They reject everything. Okay, even the biblical record, it's not scientific. It's not reasonable. We deny it all. This is rationalism. Identifying Christianity with culture. Christianity is not the only one religion, okay? This is has some limitation by geography, by time, by customs, okay? So it relates with the history of Israelites. So it is not necessary to be Israelites. So we have to free from all the Israelites, all the custom of the Bibles. So they said this is not, the Christian is not the only way to salvation. This is only the culture. Okay? The last, a modalist view of Trinity. So they are not believing the traditions of Trinity. Okay, Orthodox Trinity. They twist and they distorted all the doctrines. Even not only Trinity, they are not believing in the two nature of Jesus Christ. So they forsaken all the fundamental doctrines in the Bible. So, of course, the liberal Christians, modernist Christians, they said we are Christians. We also want part of Christianity. But the J. Gresham Machen, he said in his book, Christianity and Liberalism, said, this is not the Christianity. This is the another religion. Today, I don't know how can you call this kind of religious movement, but this is not the Christianity in the Bible, he said. This is another religion. So in my country, sometimes I say the liberals is not the Christians. They attacked me. You are very stubborn and you are very dried man. You don't have any love to the other brethren. But I said, they are not my brother. Eh? And they are not even Christians. They deny all the fundamental doctrines in the Bible. How can I believe that they are Christians? They must repent. They must return back to the Bible. They must come to the traditional and orthodox Christianity.